Als toerist in de hele wereld kom je overal soms dezelfde dingen tegen. Toen ik laatst in Los Angeles was, zag ik daar Planet Hollywood. Ik dacht, hey, waarom zou iemand in Amerika nu naar Planet Hollywood gaan? Want we zitten hier in Hollywood. Maar ja, dat is nou eenmaal een hele grote keten. En er is ook een Planet Hollywood in Amsterdam. Het is iets voor de mensen die van film houden, die dus van Hollywood houden. En we praten over Planet Hollywood in Amsterdam met Tina Gable in het Engels, want daar komt zij vandaan. Welcome, Tina.
Thank you.
Planet Hollywood. Is it a chain? Is it a franchise? What is it?
It's a little bit of a combination of two. Most of the stores, or as we like to call them, restaurants, we call them stores, are company owned. We have over 80 in the world right now, and about 80% of them are corporately owned by the corporation. The other 20 are franchises.
When you say corporation, I have an idea that that some of the Hollywood stars are involved in this. Are they the owners or are they just the figureheads?
We call them aandeelhouders.
So they have a share in this?
That's correct.
Planet Hollywood, sometimes when I walk past it, I see lots of lights and lots of people there, and then you have one of your celebrities visiting. Is that like a regular event?
It comes about just about every 6 months, which is, I think, quite regular.
And so that's one of your founding fathers, your aandeelhouders, who is also a Hollywood star, comes here and pays a visit.
That's correct. Like a Stallone, a Schwarzenegger, a Bruce Willis.
Do they leave something there? I mean, I see all these memorabilia in the shop. When they come, do they leave a special thing for you?
Most of the things are already sent to us, but quite recently we had Wesley Snipes here, who is also affiliated with the restaurant, and he left us one of his costumes from his recent movie Blade.
So then you get something. You are across from Tuschinski. I think it's now called Pate Tuschinski, but okay, everybody knows Tuschinski. You have a good cooperation with those guys because they have the premieres. Eh?
We have a great relationship with Tuschinski. We work with them very, very closely, and it's just a wonderful relationship.
Are you happy with your location there?
Rembrandtsplein, you mean?
Yeah.
Very much so. I mean, obviously, being right across the street from one of the largest theaters within Amsterdam is very important to us as Planet Hollywood. Yeah.
For me, that place remembers me of the old days when there was the cinema was there. And I would go there. And when I was a very small child, I would go there. So now I see Planet Hollywood. I think, gee, part of my history is now turned into America because it is fairly American. Huh?
Yes, the concept of naturally is American. However, we have a lot of people that come there and talk about the Rijksdaalder. It is a monumentgebouw. Which means that people, we can't do anything to the interior. So the interior of the building, although we've decorated it, still holds the original form. So we have the mezzanine and the different departments where the VIP room, which is currently our VIP room, is the old projection room. So all of those are still there. It's just in a Planet Hollywood style.
Now, there's a shop there where you sell shirts and stuff like that. But there's also food. Now, is the food here different from, say, the food in Planet Hollywood in Hollywood?
No, the food quality is very well maintained throughout the different Planet Hollywoods. We have a corporate chef that travels around and makes sure that, you know, the Cajun salmon served by us is the same that you would find in Los Angeles or in Paris or in London. We really try to keep a very close control on the quality of our food. As far as being different from Dutch food, naturally it is. It's we call it California cuisine, so it's a little bit of Mexican, a little bit of Italian, lots of...
What kind of wines do you have?
What kind of wines? We have California wines.
Oh, California wine. People won't believe, but they have wines there. Well, they have wine in South Africa and then Californian wine. Is that popular or do people ask, oh, I want French wine or something?
Well, with the kind of a restaurant that we are, people don't request French wine because we're sort of, you know, a very informal restaurant. We're not a linen tablecloth and candlelight restaurant. We are, you know, fast and good food at a great price.
Would you say that your portions are larger than the average in Amsterdam? Because that's the feeling I have about American food.
Are you trying to tell me you've never been to us?
I've never been to one.
Shame on you. No, the portions are quite large. They are really...
Actually, I did go to one in Disneyland, the new Disney Quest place in Los Angeles. And there was a big Planet Hollywood there.
Yeah?
I think I had, I don't know what. Hamburger.
Hamburger. Well, we do have hamburgers and the pastas and the pizzas and the salads, but all the portions are quite American standard, which are larger.
Which is a lot, yeah. When you're in America, you realize that the people eat more, and some of the, they grow a little bit fatter. Now, apart from the food, why do people come to Planet Hollywood? Is it for the feeling that they say, hey, I'm going to the movies, I go to Planet Hollywood first?
I think it's for the experience. It's you sit in with all those. We have almost 300 different pieces out of different films hanging in the restaurant, with all a little plaque that tells you what film it's from and who wore it. It's a little bit of a museum, a little bit of entertainment, and again the great food at a great price.
But you have to love the movies.
I think you have to have an interest in movies, because otherwise the theme wouldn't be so much for you. But like, kids love it, older people like it, because we do a lot of clips where we verzamel stukjes van dezelfde idee, zeg maar, zoenen. Dan hebben we een heel leuke clipje van al, nou zeg maar, 20 verschillende films.
All about kissing.
Yeah.
But, you know, and how long are you in Amsterdam now?
I've been in the Netherlands for 4 years now.
Are you asking? And you spreek ook een beetje Nederlands?
Ik spreek een beetje Nederlands. Sometimes it's easier to speak Dutch than it is to speak English.
What do you like about Amsterdam?
What do I like about Amsterdam? Everything.
Well, let's start it. Marijuana?
No, that would not. I enjoy the culture, the canals, the freedom of the people, just the way the city feels. I was just recently in London, and I just couldn't wait to get back here.
Is it something? Does it have something to do with the scale? I mean, you can walk from the one side of Amsterdam to the other side in half an hour, and in fact in the center it's 15 minutes. If you do that in Los Angeles, it takes you about 3 days, I think, to walk. Eh?
Yeah, I lived 10 years in Manhattan as well, and it is a different kind of feeling. I don't think it's the quaintness of it. Again, I think it's a general feeling of the way that the city has, and I think you would experience that as well.
Yeah, sometimes. When I go to America, especially New York, Manhattan, I feel the clock is ticking faster there, isn't it?
Absolutely.
Yeah. And when I go to Los Angeles, it's so big. I'm overwhelmed. If you take a boulevard there, it never ends, and it, you know, it goes from one neighborhood to another neighborhood. Whole, you come to Chinatown, and you come in, and it's so big that I feel a small nothingness in Los Angeles. That's, I don't like Los Angeles for that reason. I like San Francisco because it reminds me of Amsterdam. This feeling that you are at least something in the city.
Well, I just also think it's the structures here. Everything is just, it's so well maintained. It's clean, you know, the buildings, historical monuments are appreciated.
Do you feel we are a rich country?
Yeah, rich is a very broad term.
Are you in those terms, a well-kept?
A well-kept country, absolutely, absolutely.
What would you like to change in Amsterdam if you could?
People's perception about it, especially tourists.
You have a problem with like parking in Amsterdam? Because Planet Hollywood isn't exactly in a good parking location, are you?
Well, we have the Stopa right nearby, and that's
where many people park.
That's where we tell people to go and park. It's a moderate price. It's very close by, and quite often, you know, there are spaces available.
Mm-hmm. Do you do anything special in the coming months for? I don't think you do for Sinterklaas, would you?
As you would know, we have a Sinterklaas menu.
You have a special Sinterklaas menu. And a Christmas menu, too?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, Santa Claus menu.
We have a
we have Sinterklaas in Holland and Santa Claus.
Sinterklaas menu, and then we have a Kerstmenu. And the Kerstmenu is for groepen boven de 10 personen.
So, if you want to have a special Christmas dinner, you can go to Planet Hollywood and have an American style of dinner. Yeah?
Absolutely.
Okay, well, we have a look at your place too, and it will be the first time for me, so looking forward to seeing Planet Hollywood. Thank you, Tina.
Thank you.
Goedendag, mijn naam is Roberto Matlene. Ik werk hier in Planet Hollywood en wij hebben hier een aantal specialiteiten, waaronder de Cajun Salmon en de Chicken Fajitas onder andere. En met het kerstmenu gaan we onder andere een presentatie maken van de gerechten met lamsvlees. Dan wel op een Amerikaanse manier gepresenteerd, zoals met Cajun kruiden. En onder andere de blackened lamb. Dat is een speciaal gerecht hier. Het is een drie gangen menu. En daar kan afgewisseld worden en ook daarvan is de prijs afhankelijk van. Wat wij verder doen zijn een aantal gerechten die gepresenteerd worden op grotere borden om een betere presentatie daarvan te krijgen. Wij doen dat precies hetzelfde zoals dat we dat doen in Amerika. Er zijn alleen een paar kleine verschillen en dat is afhankelijk van het land waar we in zitten. Er zijn 83 Planet Hollywoods en deze Planet Hollywood die wordt een heel klein beetje aangepast, ongeveer voor 10% naar de Nederlandse markt.